Welcome. Today I'm going to show you the 5 steps how to program a repeater. My name is Vince and let's get started. Step number one is the offset. Now for a repeater to work, it has to transmit on one frequency and receive on another frequency. The difference between these frequencies is called the offset. For VHF, it's 500 Hz, and for UHF, it's 5,000 Hz. Step number two is the direction. It could either be plus or minus 5,000 or 600. So that's called the direction. You'll have to set either a plus or minus symbol. Step number three is the tone. Now with the tone, you could have it off, which means anybody can transmit or receive. But if you have another close by repeater on that same frequency, they'll be interfering with you. So you have a thing that's called a tone. When you set the tone, you have two choices, tone or tone encode / CTCSS. Now the encode means it sends a low pitch frequency on the bottom of the carrier the whole time you're using the repeater. And this tone tells the repeater to open up, it's okay to transmit. Now the CTCSS on some radios does the same thing for transmit, but it also does it for receive. There'll be a return tone that says it's okay to open up the receive so the person with the tone can listen. And there's multiple tone frequency settings. The next step, tone frequency. And I believe they run from somewhere around 87 up to like 176 in increments. So you'll have to check the repeater you're programming and make sure you get the right tone. And the last step is the memory. You need to know how to set the memory so you can save all these settings once you load them. So you'll set the memory, and then while doing that, you'll have to pick the memory number. And with most radios, you've got to make sure you raise it by one number every time you save a new frequency, or you'll just keep recording over the frequency you just done. And then after you hit the save button, it's going to give you a choice to name the frequency with a tag ID, which could be the name of the repeater, or I like to just leave the frequency number. This way I can get used to which repeater has which frequency. And when I'm talking to someone, I can just give them that frequency. Then they can look it up and find the other information on their own. Now, the reason I didn't go over how to do this with a radio is because a lot of radios are different. They all have the same settings, but it'll be different how you go about finding them or using them. So that, unfortunately, I'm going to leave up to you. But you know the 5 steps, and that should get you started. Remember to like, subscribe, and ding that bell. Thank you, 73.